Hello learners, welcome back. This is a short and crisp video which will get you started with SQL. And do subscribe to our channel so that you keep yourself updated on the latest technologies. So we'll start off by creating an employee table which will comprise of employee ID, employee name, the employee's salary, age and gender, and the department in which the employee works. After which we'll insert some records into this employee table and then we'll fetch records with a select statement. Then we'll use the where clause to impose a condition while fetching the records. And finally, we'll use the AND OR operators to impose multiple conditions. So this is the syntax to create a table. Creating a table involves naming the table, defining its columns, and each column's data type. So let's go ahead and create a first table. So for that, I'll type create table and give the name of the table, which will be employee. And I'll list down all of the column names. So our first column would be employee ID. And this will be of integer data type. And I'll also add not null constraint. So this basically signifies that all of the cells of this column need to have a value. Then the next column would be employee name, which is of type varchar. So varchar stands for variable length character, and the maximum length of this column could be 20 characters. Then the next column is employee salary, which is of integer type. Then we have employee age, which is integer again. Then we have gender of the employee, which is of varchar of length 20. Then we have the department to which the employee belongs, and this will be varchar again of maximum length 20. We'll also go ahead and add the primary key constraint. So primary key helps us to uniquely identify all of the records in the table, and it needs to be kept in mind that a table cannot have more than one primary key. And for this table, we are assigning the employee ID column as the primary key. Right. So I'll put a semicolon to end this create table statement, and let me execute this now. So we have successfully created the employee table. Now it's time to insert records into the table. So the SQL insert into statement is used to add new rows of data to a table. So let's insert some records into the employee table. So for that, I'll type insert into, then I'll give the name of the table employee followed by the values keyword. So let's insert the first record. So I'll give the ID, which is 1. Then the name of the employee, which is Sam, the salary, let's say he earns $75,000, his age is 32, and he's male, and he works in the operations department. Let me put a semicolon and execute this. Right, so we have successfully inserted our first record. So similar to this, we'll insert 5 more records. Right, so we have successfully inserted 6 records into our table. Then we have SQL select statement, which is used to fetch data from the table. So let's say I would want to select the name and gender columns from this data set. So for that, I'll type select ename, comma, egender from, I'll give the name of the table, which will be employee. So let me execute this now. Right. So we see that we have these two columns, the name of the employee and the gender of the employee. Now, if you wanted to select all of the fields from the table, so we can use the select star from table name command. Right, so select star from employee will give us all of the rows and all of the columns. So we have all of the fields from the data set. Then we have SQL where clause, which is used to filter records on the basis of a condition. So now let's use the where clause to select only the male employees from this data set. So I'll type select star from employee where I'll give the column first gender equals male. Right. So we see that there are 4 employees in total. Now similarly, if you wanted only those records where the gender is female, then the command would be select star from employee where e gender equals female. Let's execute this now. So you see there are 2 female employees, Anne and Julia. Next we have AND operator. So with the help of AND operator, you can implement multiple conditions. The AND operator displays only those records where all the conditions are evaluated to true. So let's say I would want to select all of those male employees whose salary is greater than $100,000. So let's use AND operator for that. I'll type select star from employee. I'll use the where clause to give the first condition where gender equals male, and then the second condition would be salary is greater than $100,000. Right, so let's execute this now. With the help of AND operator, we have implemented two conditions. So the first condition is the employee should be male, and the second condition is the employee should also have a salary greater than $100,000. So we see that there are two male employees, Bob and Jeff, whose salary is greater than $100,000. Next, we have OR operator. So the OR operator displays records for any condition which is evaluated to true. Now let's say I would want to select all of those employees who belong to either the sales department or the operations department. So let's use OR operator for that. Select star from employee where I'll type out the department is either sales, and we'll use OR operator to give the next condition, which will be the department is equal to operations. So let's execute this now. So these are the three employees who either belong to the operations department or sales department. So Sam and Matt belong to the operations department and Jeff works in the sales department. So this brings us to the end of the first video in SQL playlist. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for the next video in the playlist.